Last week, I got this toy for us to play with.
It's this little device that you put into your underwear.
Oh my gosh, really?
Yes. And it has this button, and you push the button and it acts like a vibrator. And I like already have it planted in my underwear, so I'm like ready to go. And kind of just handed him a remote and was like, here you go.
What's this?
It's for me to know and you to find out.
Whoa, wait, is that buzzing coming from?
Take control and find out.
Oh.
The supermarket was just our first stop on our like list of things to do that day.
So why not give it a shot there? It was the first place we could be in an area that there was other people and to see her reaction.
So I like have a bag in one hand and my apple like in another, and I'm just like checking it out, and all of a sudden I start like buzzing again. I'm like, okay, like this is feeling like really good. Like I'm staring obviously way too long at this one apple. I'm like, wow, this is getting really intense.
Well, I kind of was still in a funny mood because I'm still thinking that I was the one that made her fall down. So when I approached her, I was like, wow, was it good?
Whoa, was that good? Hey, Ashley, hey, are you okay?
It really hurt.
Oh, baby, you got a huge lump on your head.
His idea was to take me to the emergency room.
Come on, we gotta go. We gotta get to the hospital.
When we got to the ER, it didn't really go into much detail.
Hey, how hard did you hit your head?
She hit it really hard. I'm worried about her.
All right, we'll get a nurse to take you to the ER bay.
I still had the thing in my pants. I like totally forgot it was still in there.
Babe, the button is stuck.
Oh, I forgot, I even still had this on.
Hurry, everything's gonna be okay.
The nurse is coming.
I'm trying to turn it, it's not turning on.
What is going on here?
One of the most embarrassing moments of my life. Oh my gosh.
Hello there. I see that.
To explain that to somebody that is a complete stranger, like you have no idea.
I didn't just slip and hit my head in the supermarket. We have a remote control vibrator and it is in my pants still, and it was really intense, so like.
Well then, the nurse is gonna take you down the hall for a CAT scan. I suggest you remove anything foreign before you get inside the machine.
Of course.
Thanks for your patience. Have the results of Ashley's CAT scan.
Is she gonna be all right?
Ashley has a minor concussion. She's gonna have to take it easy for a few days. Rest and drink plenty of water.
Great, so there's no permanent damage?
No, none at all. You dodged a bullet. However, I would suggest that you keep the fun and games at home and not in a public place.
Yep.
Okay, carry on, kids.
It's happening again. He can't breathe. He can't breathe. Oh my God.
Let's restart the epinephrine drip.
He has an EpiPen.
EpiDrip will work better.
You have an EpiPen? Why didn't you use it?
An EpiPen is a self-injecting pen with adrenaline, epinephrine in it, and will abort most allergic reactions before they can get bad.
Connie, what happened?
I don't know, he just suddenly couldn't breathe again.
Now we were starting to get really worried because he's having a relapse and we're having no idea what the exposure is.
Did you touch any of the IVs or the equipment?
No.
You're sure you didn't do anything?
They got to meet under pretty stressful circumstances.
How long have you been seeing Jeff? This is our second date.
How did you meet?
Through friends.
Which friends?
We met on a dating site.
On the internet? You see what happens? You see?
I don't get it. Is he allergic to me? Why is he getting worse?
Have you used any new makeups, creams, deodorants since the last time you guys went on a date?
No.
In the back of her head, she's thinking maybe this was something she did.
Connie, did you eat anything with peanuts the last few hours?
I had a peanut butter sandwich for lunch. But I brushed my teeth.
Connie.
What is me in love?
We're brushing a dirty in the dirty closet. Aren't you worried about that?
And I tried to stop, but she kept pushing back. I'm like, okay.
Yeah, okay. I'm like, we could be quiet at this. Like, that's what I'm thinking. I'm like,
and then
don't fool this moment.
You're crazy.
also like, oh my gosh, I miss you so much. We're gonna do this right here and right now. If somebody catches us, oh well, we're gonna get caught, but we're having fun. Hey. So it was like a door, and then on the other side of the door it was an elevator. So it was like this space about like this big, and
there's somebody coming.
That made it more exciting, though, because the fact that we possibly could get caught.
Okay, I don't think anybody's there.
Even if there
was. We're probably there like 20 minutes or so. Yeah, probably about 20 minutes we're in the closet. So it was fun. It was crazy. I just popped my collar, literally. I flipped my collar up like I'm the man. I wiped the sweat off my forehead.
Where to? You okay?
Yeah, I'll be fine.
This maid of honor, right in the middle of the wedding, decided to profess her love and affection for the groom.
Hi. What do they expect me to say, you know?
She wanted to marry him and wanted to be his wife, but in actuality, her best friend wound up marrying this man.
Give me a finger stick, please.
And in an act of, I guess, rebellion or an act of attention, decided to drink an entire fifth of whiskey, literally chugging it from start to finish.
Did you take any medications, any drugs of any kind?
I love her, you know, even if she hates me.
And not only did she do this in the middle of the dance floor.
I guess you're gonna have to change those scrubs after all.
But she had done it after she had just consumed the entire wedding dinner. She literally started vomiting the entire contents of her stomach. Massive amounts of vomit. This is not like the Friday night drunk guy that just gave me the present on my shoes. This is vomit. Projectile, high volume, high amount, over and over and over again.